Mama.
You want that?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Amen. And I receive your authority. Preach your word. Bless us. In Jesus' name. With understanding. And with obedience. Two things. We need to understand the command of God, and we need to obey those commandments or commands. Amen? Say amen.
Amen.
Ready for that PowerPoint. All right, so today, probably the rest of the year, I'm going to be preaching about prayer. Prayer is so important to a Christian's life. So important. Without prayer, we don't allow the words of God to pour out of our mouths and our hands. Can't. But the word of God is truth. And we need to speak what? Truth. Amen. So, we're going to just talk about prayer. Now, prayer is important because it establishes a relationship with God. To go to God, you have to have faith. Did you know that? When we go to God, we go by faith. Because we can't see Him, we have to have faith that He's there. When we arrive at the throne room, He's there, ready to meet our needs. Amen?
Yeah.
All right. So to set up a successful relationship with God, you need to have a regular devotion time. You need to take up time with God every day, okay? Now, I say that all the time, but we need to hear it constantly. Amen? Daily devotion time, it will allow us to enter the throne room and meet with the Lord every day. Every day. All right? So, if you don't have it in your schedule, put it in your schedule. Okay? All right. So look, you have the right to total healing. Or total health. You have the right to prosperity. You have the right to good family relationships. And you have the right to peace. Did you know that? As a child of God, you have those rights. Did you know?
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
I need one more thing. Yes. So, these things you are familiar with, right? Total health, prosperity, good family relationships, peace, you know. These things maybe you're not familiar with. So, you have the right to approach God. Did you know that?
Yes.
You, as children of God, you have the right to go to God. and no one can stop you but you. The devil can't stop you from going to God. Can't. No one can. You have the right to bind and cast out demons and devils. Did you know that? Whatever Jesus did on the earth, you are able. You have the right to do it too. Jesus, he walked on water. You have a right if you want. If your faith is that, you can too. Did you know that? Yeah. You can release angels to come here on the earth from heaven. You can say, God, send angels for these reasons. And God will release angels for you to do kingdom business on the earth. You have the right to call those things that be not as though they are. You can't see it in the natural, but in the spirit you can, and you call it. I declare in the name of Jesus. From nothing God said, let there be light. And what happens? He called those things were be not like they were. And what happened? It happened. It was. Amen?
No.
I said amen.
Amen.
I need you guys to help me preach. And I say amen. Amen. You say
amen.
Amen. A hearty amen.
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 All right. Okay. Now, we have the right for those things, but we also have the responsibility to obey God, to pray, to help the poor and the needy, to love one another. We have a responsibility to love one another. Wow. We have a responsibility to forgive. The Word of God says that we are made in His image. He is a forgiver. We need to be a forgiver. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. A few amens on that one.
Oh, come on.
Oh, there's two you can't see. So, look, two more. So, watch. And then you have a responsibility to let faith abound on the earth. It should grow on the earth, the faith. Because when you have faith and others see it, it starts something new in them. And they want, they hunger, they for that faith. Yeah. That's when lust is good, when it's a good thing or a God thing. It's good to want a lot. Amen? I hear Brother Nelson loud and clear. He said, amen. And the other, go back, Dave. There was two they couldn't see. It was on the bottom. The slush. The slide before that. And the last thing that we have a responsibility to usher other people to Christ Jesus. Okay? Oh, you can. Kenzie, thank you. You're awesome. Okay. So, prayer. That's our lesson today. We deserve a relationship with God because Jesus died for our relationship with God. We were before we accepted Jesus Christ. And now, because we have accepted, surrendered ourselves, we can have that separation now in Christ Jesus. All right. The second, we deserve a chance to obey God. God commands us to pray. Okay? It's a command. Pray. All right. What is prayer? It's a request for help. It's an expression of thanks to God. Okay? Prayer is what? It's a religious service. Prayer is what? It's the practice of the presence of God. What we did this morning was our practice of the presence of God. That was prayer this morning. Prayer, it's a needful practice of Christians. We need to pray. It's needed. It's hafu hafu. Prayer, it's the exercise of faith and hope. It's the privilege of touching the heart of God. Prayer is like talking to your best friend who loves you unconditionally. That's prayer. All of those things. Prayer is translated various ways in the Bible. The translations are prayer, to wish, to promise or vow, or it's a prayer. Okay? So prayer is translated various ways in the Word of God. The first one, pray, you can find it in, let me do the Greek. Okay, it's yakoue. It means to pray. Yeah. It's Greek. All right, so look, we can find it in James chapter 5, verse 16. It says, so always tell each other the wrong. Oh, always tell. Tell them wrong things? No. Always tell each other the wrong things you've done. Then pray for each other. Do this so that God can heal you. Anyone who lives the way God wants can pray and great things will happen. Will. Okay? So it is that pray. You can go and meet with God. Amen. Like the first, this one, it means the same, but it's like to wish, okay? But it's the same word, but they would use it to mean to wish or wish, okay? It can be found in Romans chapter 9, verse 3. You say?
Bad.
It's the same. And it says, for my own people, they are my brothers and sisters, my earthly family. I wish I can help them. I would even have a curse on me and cut myself off from Christ if that would help them. Okay? I would never pray that, but I don't want a curse on me. You know, you want, but look, Jesus, he died for us. Our curse, he allowed to be put on him on the cross. He took everything, all of our sin, our curses, everything. I wouldn't want to do that. But Jesus did it for us.
Well,
imagine that.
Well, yeah.
All the ugliness and dirtiness inside a person, Jesus, he took it on himself. Not one man, not one woman, but the whole world.
Yes.
My sins, different than his, different than yours and yours and yours. But Jesus, he, all the sin of the world, every person. Past, present, future. That love. UK. It means a vow or a promise. Okay? It can be found in Acts chapter 21, verse 23. It says, so we will tell you what to do. Four of our men have made a prayer to God or a UK. I keep forgetting how to say it. UK. Alright? So they made a vow to God. Alright? Also means a prayer, okay? UK can be found in Matthew's, James chapter 5, verse 15. If such a prayer is offered in faith, it will heal anyone who's sick. The Lord will heal them. If they have sinned, he will forgive them. Okay? So, that word, if a prayer, okay? Why should we pray? Why pray? Because TV said, because God will hear you. Okay? But you have to believe that God will hear you. If you don't believe that God will hear you, you're praying in vain. Okay? You're thinking, will not happen. That doubt blocks your prayer. The Word of God says you have to go pray believing that will happen. That already. Amen? You have to go saying, it's already finished. It's already done. God commands us to pray. That's the first reason. Okay? Even though we have benefits from prayer, we pray because God says pray. All right? In Matthew's chapter 26 verse 41, it says, keep alert. Pray. Keep alert. Pray. Otherwise, temptation will overpower you. For through the Spirit, though the Spirit is willing enough, the body is weak. So keep alert and pray. You can't just be alert only. No. But you have to pray also. Okay? Luke chapter 18, verse 1. It says, then Jesus, he told his disciples a parable to show them that they should always pray and not give up. Never give up. He said that Jesus, he, to show them, to teach them, always pray, never give up. Always
pray,
never give up. Amen. That one went all the way in. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 18, it says, and pray in the Spirit on all, with all kinds of prayers and
requests.
With this in your mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints. Okay? So, another scripture telling us to always pray. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
One more. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 8, it says, I want men everywhere to pray. Men who lift up their hands in prayer must be devoted devoted to God and please Him. They must be men who keep themselves from getting angry and having argument. This scripture specifically talks about men, okay? So men, we have to pray. The women, they pray and pray and pray and pray. And if you see, if you enter this room on Sunday or on a Wednesday, you will see the women are, and the men are over there eating. And Bob said, because I'm hungry, man. You can fast until after the service. Hungry, man. I'm hungry, Pastor. All right. Okay, so man, look. So I'm going to show you some scriptures with benefit for prayer, okay? Women, you can continue to pray more and more and more too, okay? Don't stop because I said the men have to pray more, okay? Continue, more and more and more, okay? We all should want more and more of God, okay? Because prayer is just taking up time with God and talking with God like He is your best friend, because He is. Okay?
Amen.
Or you are His best friend, okay? He is still God. All right. Let's keep it that way. That He is God and you are His best friend, but He's not your best friend. He's God Almighty. Okay? Because some people they like to treat God like a best friend, but no. We need to remember that God is God Almighty. He created each of us and can us. Okay? He can just take us out. Alright? So, don't treat Him like a best friend. Treat Him like Almighty God.
Amen.
Period. You will have no problems. All right. So, the benefits, what are they? The benefits of prayer, it changes the person who's praying. Okay? It develops our relationship with God, and it gives to us a peace that surpasses all understanding.
Yeah.
Okay, so look, in Psalms 73, a man named Asaph, he was complaining, because he saw the evil, wicked people. They were advancing, they were collecting money, they were becoming rich. And he was like, oh, I'm a believer in the Almighty God and I am stuck with these people. He was complaining and he was all so upset. But he said, but when I enter the presence of God, I am changed. I am changed. Let's see that. He says, after he's been, you know, with God, he's just been letting it all out. And then verse 21, he says, I am so stupid. I thought about these people and I became upset. God, I was upset and angry with you. I acted like a senseless animal. He says, but I am always with you. You hold my hand. You lead me and you give me good advice. This morning, her testimony, her prayer. And then later, you will lead me to glory. The evil, wicked people, the unbelievers will not enter his glory. We will. Why are we upset? Why are we complaining all the time? We have to look at the end of the thing. Our end is right now. We have eternal life. This day is part of that eternal life. It doesn't start when Jesus returns. It's now. It's now. Today is part of our eternal life. Today. Not later. Now. I was so stupid. That's what verse 21 says. I was so stupid, God. I took my eyes off the prize. The prize. I have everything. Even though in my life it doesn't look that way. I have everything. They have money and some other things that I want, but God, he promised that he will supply all of my needs. Do I believe that or no?
Yeah.
I have to believe that his word is true. It said in verse 25, in heaven, God, I have only you. And if I am with you, what on earth can I want? Maybe my mind and body will become weak, but God is my source of strength. He is my strength. He is mine forever. It says, God, people who leave you will be lost. You will destroy all who are not faithful to you. As for me, all I need is to be close to you. I have made the Lord God my place of safety. And God, I tell you all about it. I tell you about all that you have done. Look, God knows, but we need to express those truths that he has poured in us already. Whatever truth is in, express it to God. Because while you're expressing those truths to God, God cancels out all of that anger and all of that bitterness and all of that complaining. God said, when you, oh, ooh, I'm on earth, ooh, right? You come to yourself, you're like, ooh, I'm happy.
Yeah.
I can start my day now.
Yeah.
And all the problems that were and affect you emotionally, they will not that day. Because you've gone to the throne room and you allow God to change you. Amen? In that change, you're developing your relationship with God, and God is giving you peace. Also, prayer benefit is it alleviates the anxiety you have. What will happen? Will happen? What? You don't know the future. God knows. So when you go to God in prayer, He shows you the future. He shows you the things you should be concerned about today. Don't be worried about them, but put them on your plate to do these things only. Okay? Oh, we're wrapping up. Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 and 7, it says, don't worry about anything, but pray. Ask God for everything you need, always giving thanks for what you have. Remember last week we said we have to be content. That's it. Giving thanks for what things you already have. Some people say, I don't have anything.
No.
You have something.
Yeah.
God wants you to be satisfied, content with the things you have. You woke up that morning. That's a good thing. You could be dead. Okay? So you thank God for that. Okay? Some people, they want to die. But when you wake up, another chance to be right before God.
Yeah.
His mercies are new every day. Amen?
Amen.
And because you belong to Christ Jesus, God, His peace will stand guard, protect you, your thoughts and your feelings. Your thoughts and your feelings. You know what that involves? Your soul. Your soul is not saved. Your spirit is saved, but your soul is still working out salvation. Okay, so it says that because you belong to Jesus Christ, God will give you peace and it will guard your mind and your heart, all right? Your emotions and your thought. His peace can do that. Far better than a human mind. Amen.
That's
awesome. Woo. And last, God, He draws close to you. When you pray, God, He comes down. God, He opens up a new level of your perception of Him. God allows you in more and more and more and more. And as God, He takes up, or you take up time with God, God, He pours a little bit more of Himself into you, into your life, okay? In James chapter 4, verse 8, it says, come near to God and He will come near to you. You are sinners, so clean sin from your lives. You are trying to follow God and the world at the same time. You must think pure. Everything we are thinking, noodling in the heart, in the mind, it must be about good things, godly things. Amen?
Yes.
So we're going to stop there, and then next week we're going to discuss how you start praying. Now, I challenge you guys to pray for 15 minutes this week or Wednesday. So Wednesday, we're going to give testimony on Wednesday about what happened, okay? So don't be afraid. Come and share your testimony. All right? All right. Let's close in prayer.
Choose something from my way out and finish. And he was preaching about something to the church. Say, the person of God, take me with you,
take him, put him in yourself, clothe yourself with him. His goodness, his mercy, his love, his wisdom, his protection. Clothe yourself with him. All of who he is, clothe yourself. God is with us and in us. People, they should see him when they see you. Satan does. When Satan looks at you, believers in Jesus Christ, he only sees Jesus. The light of Christ illuminates your whole self. Amen?
Yeah.
Father God, thank you for your presence today. Thank you for illuminating our minds and our hearts. Thank you for promising to protect us, shield us from the evil one. Thank you for promising to come close to us when we come close to you. Thank you for these words, these scriptures about prayer. We ask that you allow Holy Spirit to teach us, reminding us all of the things you've said in your word today. Write it on the walls of our hearts that we will not sin against you, but we will purpose in our minds and our hearts to come to you daily, that you will enjoy us. It's why you created us, to love and enjoy us. As your children on the earth, we ask your blessing of authority and power over the enemy. We thank you for protection and provision and wisdom. We ask that you use us powerfully as we clothe ourselves with your mercy, your grace, your wisdom, and your shield of protection. In Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Bless you.